Sandy's boat. As you can see, there are two tapes here. Because I want the student to have the tape on here so they know where to grab it. Because sometimes you see people do this, sometimes you see people do this. So this is in thirds. When the tape is no longer on the stick or start to coming off, then that's when you get rid of the tape. You no longer leave it on the tape. Here's what most people do. They start on the tape really good, just like this, but then they come around and they're over here. See, or they come around and they're over here, or they're over here. See, and that's not in thirds. So if I'm in here, I know right when I feel that tape where I'm supposed to be. And when you've done it for enough time, you don't need the tape. But right now, you know, we use the tape so that she can get used to what she's doing with it. So that's what the tape is for. All right, so, 11th basic, get on guard. If we're doing this here, like this here, right? And I'm coming in here, like this. Here's what I see a lot of people do. It's not exactly incorrect, but it's not disarming either. I see people come knee and then hand, and then they come here. So it looks something like this. One, two, down. So look, one, two, down. One, two, down. When you do it that way, you lose the opportunity to disarm. So I want to knee and hand right across my elbow. Knee, I want to run this right across my elbow and then down. So when I'm in here, and I come in here, I know when I come back, it's automatically going to be on the hand. Come down right along my elbow. It's the way it is. It has to be there. Once it's here, then I want to come in here and grab that wrist. And then strike here. He gets on guard. As soon as he tries to get it, I want to hit that hand and then smash that wrist. That's what we're doing. Thank you.